What's good, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Today we are finally back after about 3 weeks with unboxings of boxes that we found deep in the abyss. Like, we found these around the house, in the garage, in the backyard, all over the place, and we're finally here to unbox it. Some of it's new, some of it's really old. We're just gonna break down as much of it as we can and get through it as fast as we possibly can. But today is also the day, Black Friday. You know, Black Friday, with COVID going on, you can't really do it that well. If you take a gander at what we did today. Yo, easy 20 clip today, easy 20 clip. And this isn't all, we had griddles. We got griddles, that's right, you know, little grilling stations. We got griddles for $10 from $40. We got little these mystery eggs for like 20 bucks. They go for like 80 bucks on eBay. So today was a really, really good low-key flips type of day. The group's been killing it. Yesterday we had Home Depot price errors. Then we had the coin that we made like $1,000+ profit on because we caught like three of them. We got a restock monitor in there. And if you guys want to join the group, make sure you check us out on Wednesday at 8 p.m. Eastern. You guys will see some of the information up on the screen. That's all you got to know. We'll drop on the website, 8 p.m. Eastern, $40 a month. We break down Pokemon, Yu-Gi-Oh, MTG, Magic the Gathering. For all you young kids out there might not know what that is. We got low-key flips, daily fantasy sports, trivia, sneakers, of course, streetwear. Oh, it's good stuff. It's good stuff. And we're about to make some good profits on that eventually, because that deal was found at a lot of places. So, without further ado, we're going to get right into it as fast as we possibly can, but as thorough as we can. Looks like first up, we're starting off with a banger of a shoe. We got a little bit of a Kobe. Kobe Bryant actually going down right here, size 9. I don't even know if this is mine. Oh, yes, it is. We got this one right over here. This is another one of the recent Kobe's. Once again, I love Kobe, don't get me wrong, but I just wasn't the biggest avid follower of his work, of his athleticism. So, shoe smelling on point, but I'm just, that's a B, baby. That's a B. We're going to put this shit to the side. I just wasn't too crazy about him when he was playing too much. I'm just not the biggest basketball fan, but we're starting off with another banger. Listen, we got a little bit of an Air Jordan 1 box. I think I might know what this is. Yes, sir. We got a pair of the beautiful, also limited Jordan 1 Dark Mochas. You guys are so with the in-hand early review on these. We got only about 4 pairs at the moment. Right now, we're trying to go for snipes. Today, we're filming it the same day this video is hopefully going out, and we're still in queue on snipes, so we'll see how that ends up going. But honestly, don't think it's going to go too well. Next up, we got another Jordan 1 box. You guys will see what these are as expected. Pair of the Lucky Greens, which in hand quality, if you can zoom in, I don't know if you can pick it up too well, it's not that crazy. It was kind of a letdown, thought it would be a lot better, but it is what it is. Does come nice. Ooh, this shoe tag already broke off. It is what it is. These are also known as like the fake Heinekens. Like, they're basically based off the Heineken SBs. Here we go into another banger. As you can see though, it's a lot of Nike tape. Shouts out to Nike for blessing your boy. This is a small, I got a big ass head and this shit's smaller than my head. That's crazy. A little shoe, but dude, these are Mad Mag 2. Do you see this shit? Look at my hand, bro. This is a 5C if I'm not mistaken. Really, it comes with mini laces too. That's some cute shit right there. So these are the rubber dunks. We got a shit ton of all infants and preschools. We got 2 pairs of men's, ended up getting 2 pairs of them, which was not the best bet, but it is what it is. We ideally wanted a lot of men's to invest in, but price is already slowly going up with them. Looks like we got another Jordan box. This is the Jordan 1 mid. Oh no, what is... I don't even remember ordering this shit, not gonna lie, but this is the gold swoosh Jordan 1 lows. Haven't seen these in store at all, actually. They might have been a Nike exclusive, not too sure, but you know, Jordan 1 mids and lows, and leather on these is amazing. If you can pick that up, that tumble leather right there, this is what I love. I love tumble leather on all Jordan 1s, but they don't be bringing it back as much as I think they should be. Here we go on to another one. This is looking like it's gonna be some clothing. Yes, this is probably like the ugliest shirt from the Union collab. If you didn't know, we took an L on Jordan Union, and this is the only thing we got. This is the t-shirt with the big ass graphic on the back. $50 retail right here. It's not it. It's definitely not it. And hopefully we have one massive package. I know that's it. Is this it? No, this is not it. But this is something else that's looking too good. We got a double clip. This is also from Snipes. Only reason I can tell, because Snipes is the only store I managed to double card on. So it looks like we got over here a pair of the Jordan 1 mids right here. We already had a bunch of these in the last unboxing, so not gonna break those down too much. And then we had another pair of these right here. GS sizes, always a solid investment. Fake Unions is what a lot of people are calling that shoe. And once they give a little fake denomination to a specific sneaker, it tends to get more hype over time. But actually, sad thing is, on Kiewit system, which is the Kiew system that Snipes has on their releases, I think they're changing that up a lot. All right, here's another little low-key John right here. This is size 13 carats in Crocs. Retailing this John, I think, was about $50. Resale last time I checked was like $250. When I bought this, I haven't looked at market since. Probably dropped down a lot more. It is what it is. People don't know how to hold up market, unfortunately. But can't control everybody's actions. Looks like we got another Jordan 1 mid box. Ooh, what you know about this item? This is a little Shop Nice Kicks order. I think this is a men's or GS. Ooh, 6.5 wide. Didn't even know we ordered these, but this is like an older release. These are Chicago mid toes. We pulled members. I think this shoe right here, the Chicago mid black toe, was the one that started gaining a lot of people's interest into actually investing mids. Because literally within a year ago, the only people that were chasing mids were people living in big cities, specifically New York. And after that, it was just like people were just like sleeping on. I'm not going too crazy. Yo, what is this? What is this? Oh, Hibbets Carbons. Oh, I forgot. We never even unboxed Carbons yet. We didn't unbox all the pairs that we have. Listen, not looking too good at the moment. I told people not to bother with men's pairs. If you look at natural base size right now, though, I told people only focus on base sizes for that pair. And if you listen, if you manage to cop a few pairs, you're definitely doing pretty well at the moment. Looks like we got a Jordan 1 high box. Yes, sir. A lot of the Jordan 1 highs. Ooh, 6Y. What could this be? Oh, this was that exclusive access restock. Smoke Gray 6Y from Nike. We caught a W on the men's pair on the actual release date. GS pair, we caught an L on. Going once again into the investments category because that's just a long, long-term hold. And Mochas, I know a lot of people have been asking me if you haven't seen the latest video I dropped on Mochas. I would still wait on it. I would not consider investing just yet. I would still give it more time. Wait till the EU release happens, and then I would go from there on out. Looks like we got another... Regrettable. We have too many of these, and so does every single other reseller out there. So I feel like market is just going to be way oversaturated for that shoe. Ooh. Looks like we got another double cart of some Jordan 1 mids. Also looking at like it's from Snipes. We got a 6Y right here of the also a pretty, kind of like a rare Jordan 1 mid. Hasn't really been popping up at too many places, but GS size in these. I think you also saw an investment. Good neutral colorway. And then this one right here is, we got another one of these? Damn, 5Y. Time Boy TV Plus. What can I tell you? Random shit shows up. Not really. We ordered this probably like a minute ago. I think this was from the Snipes restock, if I'm not mistaken. I think we ordered that about, I think that might have been 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago, if I'm not mistaken. Not entirely too sure. But you know, we always on top of all the restocks and what is going on here. Looks like we have a nice little low-key flip. Way too big of a box. We got a little bit Funko action coming down. Lilo and Stitch. Hot Topic exclusive, if I can remember correctly. Not going for too much at the moment. I think it's because the restock was just a too big of a restock for them to consider holding up the market. Another Nike package we go into. Little low-key flip right here. We got the faux fur. Oh, is this the blanket or the jacket? Amazing female piece, I gotta tell you. This is the Jordan 1 faux fur jacket. Right now dropping, this is a size small, 175, but we had 20% off coupons in the group. At least I think it was for my birthday or something going down, and they ended up giving me a discount on that one. So not a bad investment at all. Unfortunately, it looks like we still got Jordan 1 mids and low boxes coming out of here. This is a 10. Oh, not unfortunately. This is actually a solid cop. I think this is a very, very good investment. Listen to me. This shoe right here, I think, is a very solid investment. You don't ever see these two colors coming on any Jordan 1. Kind of give me like a Lakers vibe, but not really there because it's a pink and not a purple. But I do think a lot of people slept on that shoe. And it was sitting in stock in GS sizes for, if I'm not mistaken, I think about a few minutes after release. I think about 8 minutes after, we still caught another pair of GS. This box is packed tighter than a motherfucker. This looks like it's another one of those Jordan 1 mids, or it might be a low. Let's see what this is. Ugliest mid we've seen in a minute. This is like one of the ugliest mids I've ever seen. But sometimes I cop a pair or two just in case it does ever go up. Because sometimes the stuff that people sleep on the most ends up going up in the most because there's the least amount of resellers holding that specific product. Another Jordan 1 mid. Well, listen, if you can't get highs, get lows and mids. Because yes, it takes a lot longer time, but it does end up being worth it. And it looks like we have another pair of these. Not gonna talk much about them. Good buttery leather over there. Let's change it up with a bit. I think this might be a little Yeezy package. They're the only ones that really pack stuff like this. Yeah, it's looking like it's an easy box. Easy box is all I gotta say. Probably my favorite box ever. Mad low key. Don't have no Just Do It tape on it, so it's not exuberant. But this is a pair of the carbons. 6.5 carbon right here. 6.5 is always ends up being a very rare and very profitable size in Yeezys. You guys can see that right there. 6.5. Voila. Inventory day is about to go crazy, ladies and gentlemen. So it looks like we have another Yeezy box right here. And rip this off. But boom, looks like we went pretty crazy on the carbons, I'm not gonna lie. Another 6.5. What is this? I swear, sometimes I don't know if they'd be sending me shoes, forgetting me shoes, or sending me too much, but it looks like we have another 6.5 of the carbon sneaker. Yeah, these are the carbons, but the official name on the box is not carbons, as Riel. And I'm pretty sure these come with extra laces as well, so make sure you check your boxes and ensure you do have that going down. Next up, we do got, JD Sports. Little restock action going down over here as well. This was a pair of the, don't tell me we got another pair of the Chicago Mid Black Toes. Oh yeah, this is when we ordered 3 pairs. This is a 4.5 wide. Once again, this was when our monitor caught this restock. I want to say before Twitter, before a lot of people caught onto that restock, because that was a little bit like a shock thing going down at a random time too. Wasn't announced or anything else like that. Looks like we got possibly another Yeezy box. We rip this open. Expose. And this is not an Yeezy box, actually. Jordan 1 Low GS. Whack. A very whack shoe, but it's a GS size. A GS size at mids and lows tend to go up a lot faster than men's, for example, or women's even, at the end of the day. But of course, it all really depends. Every mids and lows, people ask me, like, how do you know what to buy? It all depends on the colorway. If the colorway looks good to you, chances are it looks good to other people as well. It all depends, really. Another one of these, easy pass in my books. We're gonna have to hold on to those for a minute, I gotta tell you. Longer than Christmas, longer than anticipated, but it is what it is. And here we got another Jordan 1 High. Mocha's baby, please. We know whose these are. These are the Royal Toes, also from Exclusive Access, came out. This one, they had Off-White Forest, Royal Toes, Satin Red Skins, Snake Skins, I should say. And they had all that Exclusive Access going down. GS and men's is what we got in those, if I'm not mistaken. Right, so continuing on, it looks like we got another Off-White package. And this is another size. I'm telling you, we got a lot of these rubber dunks in a lot of weird sizes. 12 seat right over there. Voila. RIP to the paper. It's not that important. Don't cry about it. I know I get complaints about being a little bit too ruthless sometimes with this stuff, but it's just like, where do I put it? And I want to say, where do I put it? Next up we go. Looks like we have a small ass. Yo, look at this shit, yo. The 8C Jordan 1 Mid Lucky Green. Jordan 1 High, I should say Lucky Green. Comes in a mid box though, because it is a smaller GS size. Let's get into another Nike box. It looks like we do have, I'm anticipating this is a woman's pair of the Lucky Greens because of the red box, and indeed it is. We got a few pairs of these, actually. I think we got 5 in total. Not the greatest release either. Didn't try to go too crazy on them, just because I was hoping to go crazy on Mochas, and it was like a little bit of a test run. This is when I first started running Toru, the Toru bot action, you know what I'm saying. Looks like we got another Yeezy box over here. Not holding up too well either. This is, yeah, another one of the carbons. Not gonna bother showing that off to you. That's a nice little foot sight order. Carbons is the main easy. We do have another Jordan 1. Oh, Jordan 1 mid we do have is the woman's ochre. Yep, indeed it is. This is another good investment, I think. It's a very solid, subtle colored shoe. And this is a big ass size, 11.5 women's. So it's bound to go up in value just because it fits a 9 men's. Yeah, no, 10 men's to fit. So honestly, could correlate to a lot of male people out there, a lot of male customers. Looks like we have another Jordan 1 High box, and this might be a GS size. No, this should be 9.5 right here. Get you a little bit of some mocha action right there. Well, and once again, quality is not too crazy. I do think, and what I've been hearing, we're going to tell you guys for sure in a bit, the Midnight Navy Jordan 1s, Japan's are coming out November 14th, are a lot better quality than this. Let's actually jump in exactly a week from today. We'll have a full in-hand review for you guys early. Should be Monday or Tuesday. If you're interested, make sure you stay tuned and tapped in for that. Looks like we have another Jordan 1 mid, and this one is definitely from Chic. What did I order from Chic? Is this another one of those igloos? Yeah, it's one of those Igloo Journal One fake ass unions right there. GS sizes, always, always solid investments. Group real quick, getting a little bit too hectic out here. Oh, nice little low key John over here as well. I decided to keep this for myself. I don't really know why, because I'm not the biggest fan of rip and dip at all. And if you guys do remember, we did have one of these before. We ended up ordering two. We sold one for like $100 profit. A nice little calm piece, if I'm not mistaken. Let's open this shit up. Bubble wrap be going crazy right now. There we go. And this is the rip and dip figure. What number did we get though? 460 out of 500. Not a good number. We were hoping for something unique, like 69 or something more interesting than that. And down she goes. So, more mids and lows it looks like, unfortunately. Not the most interesting shoes, but I'm telling you, if you want to make money, it will take longer. Well, this one's a good one. I'm telling you, this is 7Y right here. I think one of the last sizes to sell out, the La Familia Jordan 1 mids. And once again, bound to go up in due time. Looks like we have another Jordan 1 high box. This is looks like to be a 4Y. What could it possibly be? We got blood stains on it, you know what I'm saying? And we got a nice pair of Royal Toes also from the exclusive access that did go down. We got men's NGS, as you guys saw previously. Continuing on, we got another box. Jumpman Nike Just Do It branding on it, of course. So yeah, this is ordered. Oh, there we go. This is another 2Y, the Lucky Green Jordan 1 highs. Solid little brick. It's not a little brick, it's a big brick. The truth. Really think the only thing that's moving out of that Lucky Green collection is some the woman sizes. That's about it. We got some G phases up there, regular action, nothing too special. And this is hopefully I don't even know what this could be. Looks like it's from Nice Kicks. Oh, shot Nice Kicks. This is a pair of the Chicago. Listen, we got more Chicago black toes like out of the little mini retail restock than we did almost initial. But here we go. We have another pair of these Manual Boys on Shop Nice Kicks. If you don't know what SMK is, it's one of the most botted websites out there, most easiest to bot sites out there as well. Another Nike Just Do It box. All right, we got more Jordan 1 mids. Not interesting to me no more. Let's see what else we got up in here. This is, looks like a Jordan Retro box. It looks like it could be Jordan 5 off whites, but it is unfortunately not the Jordan 5 off whites. This is instead Jordan 4 Fire Reds. We did drop really exclusive. This was a shock drop. First shock drop we've actually seen that went available for everybody in quite a long time. GS sizes, solid hold for now. I'm gonna wait till the official release comes out and see what happens when they do end up dropping out there. Looks like another Yeezy package, size 9 right over here. I don't even remember ordering this many Yeezys, but this was from, it looks like it's a Foot Locker purchase. Carbons right here. If you guys can look in closely, that's a Yeezy box right there as well, so not gonna bother opening that. We've already seen too many of those. Another Nike package. It looks like it's another pair of the GS. We didn't get no men's pairs. This is the GS Fire Red 4s. And just like that, you guys can peep right over there, size 7Y as well. No men's pairs. I don't know how we took an L on that because we were literally on it instantaneously. They still decided to hand us that quick L though. They didn't get them. Not really quick either. We were pending for quite some time. Another Jordan 1 mid. Let's see if this is a bit more interesting. And it is, it's actually a pair of Jordan 4s in that toe box. Yo, this don't look like no rest. This looks like some low-cut bougie. This looks like some foo-foo gaga, bro. This is not it. I mean, I know it's a 2.5Y, but that just does not look right at all. Next, we've got End, and if you know something comes from End, it's typically a little bit of a higher premium tier release. And we did get, if you didn't watch Resellers Corner, you already know, pair of the skeletons right over here. This is our second pair, and unfortunately, they were charging a bit over retail, which does cut away a lot of the profit. It did come out, I should say, around $170 per pair, which is way, way over market at the moment. So we might either do a long hold, or we might have to hit them with the quick return. We'll see how that goes. And this is, once again, the second pair. But I do gotta say, I love how End packages are clothing. It shows that they really, really do care about their customer, and this is pair number 2 right here. It was easy-ass checkout, but easy-ass checkout for paying way over retail on some kicks. So it looks like we'll grab this one right over here. I'm still waiting on one big package I do have from Snipes. One huge triple cart. Just a little bit of a... this is not. I always get excited when I see this box. I always think it's immense, but this is a nice 3Y, which is actually a little bit more of a rare size of the GS, because it almost fits a decent amount of females out there, I should say. So 3Y is actually one of the best sizes to hit out of GS sizing. So in the home stretch, last few packages, I'm telling you, we had over, I want to say, I think way over 50 packages, but you know, so while we got Chicago White Heels right here, we did order, this is a size 10.5 right here, non-sus 10.5 Chicago White Heel, good ass investment as well. It's like if you can't get Chicago Black Toes, you might as well get the White Heels, you know what I'm saying? It is what it is. Another Jordan 1 mid-box, but I've been seeing a lot of TikTok going around a lot. I don't know if you guys saw it, but it's the man talking shit about mids and lows, and a lot of people are agreeing with the man, so hopefully it doesn't affect market too much. But this is the size 12 right here, big ass size, only fitting males. But if you can get a size like a size 7.5 or a GS size that can fit like females, I feel like that's a lot easier. So I do think mids look a lot better on girls than they do on men. Just a thought I do have. No idea what this is actually. It looks like it's a Nike Air box. Could be Dunks, could be Air Maxes. What is it? Oh, it is a little event. Listen, I ain't gonna front. We did buy this pair off StockX. And that toe box is nasty, son. That toe box is nasty. We're gonna have to inspect this a little bit closer once we get inside. But I was trying to invest in a... That shoelace don't look right. I'm pretty sure it's supposed to come in a bag. Not exactly too sure. We'll look at it when we get inside. But this was a solid investment. I had like a $50 off coupon from StockX because I complained OD. If you ever have issues with them, complain. If your package is delayed, if you're not getting paid out on time, keep complaining. They'll do something for you. Eventually, they'll have to do something for you. This box is a bit up destroyed. I'm drawing one mid right here. This is a 4Y of whatever it is. And boom, whack, in my opinion. So I think this is a package I've been waiting for to see if it came in. Listen, it's non-tampered, right? We didn't tamper with it at all. We just cut it open. I gotta show you guys what's good with this. Listen, do you see this? It's as if we were a retailer. It's as if we were a freaking retailer. People doubted me. They're like, no way you triple carded, huh? Well, we did. Listen, this is a size 5.5. 5.5. Ooh, in hand, natural looking type. Nice, not gonna lie. Piss yellow, so I despise. But the upper part is actually pretty cool. It looks a lot different than it does in images. If you can get a little bit closer with that, that's like a nice lemonade yellow on that side. And that's like a washed out darker yellow on that side. So it looks like you still stepped in piss, but not as much as I thought. It's just a tad bit better looking. And we do got two sizes, two boxes, all in one order, free shipping, baby. Lucky greens right here. Not to be cocky or anything, but you know, people just sometimes doubt me manually, baby, and we got lucky greens right here. Nothing insane. I feel like triple carding mochas would have been a lot better, but mochas are still a work in progress at the time being. And if Snipes goes over to Shopify, it's a wrap. It's a wrap for manual voice, 100% for sure. Looks like we got a Shoe Palace order, which looks like it's gonna be another investment piece. Yeah, another shadow. These are popping at a lot of Foot Lockers, Foot Sites, and all the other shenanigans right now. Highly recommend chasing them. Long-term investments, though. It is shadows. We haven't seen shadows come out of Nike in a minute. And if you guys do recall, shadows were still... Look at this, another 5C right here. Look at this, a little off-white Nike Dunk green action right here. Little 5C. And our last package of the day. We're going to finish it off strong. The pair of works to be Jordan 1 mids. 7.5 Chicago White Heels, baby. That's about right. You guys saw Off-White, you guys saw Jordans. A lot of sneakers mainly. We didn't do no soft packages because they just take too long to fix up. But a little bit crazy action come down. Make sure you guys stay tuned. We might have a separate video for low-key flips and unboxings, whatever we do get from that. Hope you guys enjoyed. It's a nice, beautiful day out there. Go enjoy it. I'll catch you guys in the next one.